Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to teach you about how we can calculate the rectangular coordinates in a traverse, and the type of traverse is an open traverse. Let's say that we are being given with a traverse having four lines as A, B, B, C, C, D and D. The length and bearing of each of the line is given. So let's draw the sketch of this traverse first so that we can have an idea about this traverse. So starting with point A, we have an AB line that has a bearing of 81 degree, BC line with 65 degree as the bearing, CD line with 45 degree bearing and DE line with 30 degree bearing. Now in this traverse we are being given with the coordinates of point A, and the coordinate of B, C, D and E is required. The coordinates of the respective points can be calculated if we can calculate the departure and latitude of each of line. The departure is being calculated by the formula as L sin theta, and latitude is being calculated by the formula L cos theta, where L is the length of the line and theta is bearing in whole circle bearing system. Now, in order to have better understanding about the coordinates, let's show these coordinates with the help of departure and latitude scale. And these are the graduations on departure and latitude scale. Initially, we are at point A. So these two dots, red and green dots, are being shown on the departure and latitude scale to show the position of point A. Now the coordinate of the next point, which is B point, can be calculated if we can calculate the departure and latitude of line AB. So when we do the calculation with the formula given, we will be having the values as, now the coordinate of B point can be calculated if we add the first coordinate with departure and second coordinate with latitude, and when we add them together we will get the coordinates of B point. Now once we have got the coordinates of B point, the position can be seen on the departure and the latitude scale. The motion on departure and latitude scale is being quantified with the values of departure and latitude, that you can see the value of the departure for AB line is more as compared to the value of latitude. And now in a similar way we can move forward for the calculation of C point by calculating the latitude and departure of BC line, and when we do the calculation we will have these values as departure and latitude. Now in a similar way, the coordinates of C point can be calculated by simply adding the departure and latitude with the coordinates of B point, and when we add them together we will get the value of C point as, and same can be shown on the departure and latitude scale. Now moving further for the calculation of the coordinates of point D, for that we need to calculate the latitude and departure of CD line, and those would be added with the previous point, the C point, and once we add them together we will be having the coordinates of P point, and same can be shown on this departure and latitude scale. Now for the last point, the same procedure is being applied. We need to calculate the departure and latitude for DE line and adding them with the previous point D point, and when we add them together we will be having the coordinates of E point, and the same can be shown on this departure and latitude scale. Now at the end we have now got coordinates of all points. Now looking at these red and green dots on departure and latitude scale, we can see that their motion will solely depend upon where we are moving. If we are moving towards east for departure, it will be moving rightward, and if we are moving upward in case of latitude, then that will be positive, and if we are moving downward then it will become negative. So this is how we can calculate the coordinates of the respective points in an open traverse if we are being given with the length and bearing of each of the line. So this is all from this video. I hope now you can calculate the coordinate of the respective points in an open traverse. That's it. Thank you for watching this video.